sign them off. What the fuck? There's water in my fucking door. That's what I sound? Is that what I fucking hear? Excuse my language. Is that what I hear? Water in my door? Look, you still got your trash cans there, baby, buddy. You can put your trash cans back. Stupid liar. Yesterday I get a phone call from Dr. DeJoseph's office, I take it. They're telling me that Dr. DeJoseph's ready for his, ready to make appointments.
Yes.
His schedule is up for the rest of the year. So. Who wants to schedule what? When, where, why, and how? Why does it sound like I got water in my door? Are they trying to ruin my doors now too? Did they fucking put water in my door? Why does it sound like I got water in the door? Trying to ruin my automatic door locks too? Oh, you're fucking sabotaging every goddamn car I got. I can't wait till you get your ass beat. Sounds like I got water in my fucking door. Good job, jerk off. She talks shit. No. You fucking wanted my life. You pushed my buttons, you did some nasty shit to me, now I talk shit, you don't like it. Son of a bitch.
Should your church get involved in that messy topic of mental health?
Ooh, it's a tough one. And how some churches are responding, is it right or wrong? I'll explain after Magnify on K-Love.
I've been trying to make sense of the sorrow that I feel. Holding on for life, the only thing that's real. I've only scratched the surface. I've barely had a taste. Just a glimpse draws my heart to change. And one side of you lives.
I need to see everything. Just more of you. Take it all away. Magnify the wonder. Open up my eyes to you.
Praise God.
Take it all away. Magnify
the wonder. Open up my arms to you. My sight is incomplete, and I made you look small. I've been staring at my problems for way too long. Realign where my heart is set. Until you're all that's left. But just a glimpse from my heart to change. And one side of you lives my situation.
How's your drive? I don't know.
ending now. I get excited just thinking about my first bite, okay? Krispy Kreme offering a new Reese's Peanut Butter Donut.
Ah, oh, yeah.
With a little peanut butter filling. Should be delightful. This is kind of alarming.
I've got to get over there, buddy.
Use infant car seats correctly, and I do know a lot of fire departments and police stations will help you set that up to make sure that you have your kiddo in there safely.
5%?
5%. Only 5%. And so probably you think everything's A-okay, but maybe not so much.
Yeah,
you need to be safe for sure. Big question, should churches play a part in dealing with mental health? More churches stepping up and saying, yes, absolutely. And they're doing more things like seminars on mental health, preaching on stress, anxiety, and depression. And pastors, very interesting in this research when they're saying, what should you be preaching on and reaching out to your congregation?
Yeah.
They're saying, for so long we just ignored it, or maybe over-spiritualized it, and didn't really get to the real issue. And that can't happen anymore because so many people are facing it.
Yeah, depression is such a big deal. And, you know, maybe you need medication for it. But also this, just think about what is it our faith is. It's what's in your heart and what's in your mind.
Yeah.
So let's just put it right there. It's what you think on. Why can't we get some training or help on what we're thinking about? You know?
Totally. And as believers, when we're struggling, wherever that issue is, mental health or whatever, you can't keep it hidden.
No.
You have to reach out. And as a church, we should be the one responding and saying, yeah, we're here for you.
Oh, man. I say go for it.
Go for it. I'm Amy, and that's what's trending now.
Encouraging Kayla.
I was made to love you, I was made to hold you.
I know it's over cause my feet have hit the cold floor. Check my reflection, I ain't feeling what I see. It's no mystery. Whatever happened to a passion I could live for? What became of the flame that made me feel more? And then did I forget that
I was made to love you, I was made to find you, I was made to find you,
made to adore you,
I was made to love you.
With my eyes open wide, like in the ring, you got me swinging for the grand prize. I feel the haters spitting vapors on my dreams, but I still believe. I'm reaching out, reaching up, reaching over. I feel the breeze cover me, cause you're over.
I'm gonna give it.
Should the church be talking about mental health issues? Rochelle says yes.
Oh, wow.
Her story next on K-Love.
Word of life, speak to my weary heart, strengthen my broken.
I think this world, if more churches knew how to put the Bible and life together in one, things would be a lot, would have been a lot different if there was a different way. Everybody has their different way of teachings. So it was kind of weird. Nowadays, people are learning how to take the Bible and, I mean, you can learn how to take the Bible and apply it to your life, but to really understand the Bible and how to apply it to different passages is different. You know, with me having more of an open mind with my Bible readings and my Bible teachings, it's come into an enlightenment. It has enlightened me a lot. Learning how to deal with what's going on with the world. But understanding that, yeah, God was angry. Guess what? I'm angry. I'm letting the whole world know I'm angry and who it is. So, truth will be told, one way or another. You can only be fake and false for so long before you get busted. Yep. To go here. Hey, I bet you 10-1 the bitch that's trying to be me didn't go to Oscar Jenkins and get fish stuff, did they? Did you go to Oscar Jenkins, bitch? For fishing gear? Have you ever gone to Oscar Jenkins? No, I didn't think so. You never went to Oscar Jenkins, did you?
Really hard.
Yeah.
And halfway through the service, I realized I had been sobbing for a good 10 minutes. And my brother put his arm around me, and at the end of the service, he walked me to the
Oscar Jenkins ain't there no more, asshole. You gonna build that one back up too, like you did with Burger King? Huh? You put Burger King back up in Woodbury. So you can say that you worked there, but you didn't work there in 1995, asshole. You didn't work at Burger King in 95, jerk off. You can hypnotize yourself to say you did, but you didn't. Tell Nadine I'm sorry. No, die.
Disciples, and he said to them, hey, are you willing
to... Oh, I got a line of cars in front of me. My appointment's not till 9:40, but 9:30. I'll get there just in time.
When things get difficult, are we willing to truly press in and realize that He is our only true source of life? The words that He gives us give us hope and peace and joy.
It's the K-Love Morning Show with Skip, Amy, and Kinkle Fritz. Skip and Kinkle Fritz?
Poor Amy.
Grace was a kingdom. I stopped at the gate, thinking I don't deserve to pass through after all the mistakes that I made. Oh, but I heard a whisper as heaven bent down. Said, child, don't you know that the first will be last, and the last get a crown.
I'll call you dogs. Why don't you ask my husband? Why don't you ask my husband why my dog went nuts? Why is my cat going crazy too? Why does my cat go crazy to go downstairs every 5 seconds? She likes being downstairs. Yeah, I've never been here. Sorry, I've never been in the Shady Lane complex. Never been there. Yeah, look! Some assholes going there in my son's name, right? Did you take my son's hazardous material handler and use it for your own benefit so you can get a fucking job? Huh? Because you're a fucking loser. You couldn't do it by yourself, so you had to have my son do it and then take over my son's life. Good job when he got old enough, right? Is that what it was? Yeah, I thought so. I thought so. You're trying to have him get every job that my husband's had. Every job my husband's done is what you're trying to do for my son, right? Is that what you're doing? Every job my husband's Brandon's had so far is what my husband's done. I see the fucking pattern and you will not win. I don't know if my husband's been trying to be my son all these years, but it's not gonna work and he'll be found out. I don't know who I am. I've been Nadine's husband for so long, I don't know. Oh yeah? I want to know who's saying they're my husband. Because then I can rip his balls off. Because he doesn't deserve to be a man or a husband. Because obviously he ain't no man to stand up to me. Right? Right.
There is.
I mean, I get it. I got pulled over at when I didn't have no registration back in 2002. Or was it? Yeah. Something like that. 2001. Two times. No registration. And then again. Stupid assholes. All I had to do was present my registration and move forward.
Giving away a trip a week to Barbados. Listen weekdays at 8, noon, 2, 4, and 6 for your chance to win.
Short out my goddamn doors. Assholes are trying to sabotage my freaking electrical locks, everything. Everything.
Yeah.
1000 starting today with a new career.
Praise God, obviously I am here. Praise be to God. Hope is in front of me and my children. Peace be with us. Amen. God's to go in.